Hey everyone, I'm Liz Ferry, and today I'm going to show you how I made these realistically shaped crochet dolls. This tutorial is going to be pretty much the exact same technique as my first realistic doll tutorial, but this time I'll be showing you how to make a doll with a much thicker body type. Here's the doll that I made using the technique from my older tutorial. As you can see, this doll is a lot slimmer, and this new doll is very thick. In part 1, I'll show you how I started the upper half of the doll's body, and in part 2, I'll show you how to finish the lower body and how to make the arms. In part 3, I'll show you how to make the lower half of the body. This is going to be a fairly long tutorial series, so make sure that you subscribe so that you don't miss any episodes. To make these dolls, you'll need a crochet hook, I'll be using a size E, a pair of scissors, a yarn needle. If you like, you could use a stitch marker or bobby pin to keep track of the first stitch of your row. I'll also be using my stitch markers to keep track of certain stitches in the row to make them easier to find later, so I have a whole bunch of bobby pins. You'll need some eyes for your doll. I used some black yarn to make the eyes for my doll by tying a thick knot. If you want to see how I made these eyes, click the link on the screen for my yarn eyes tutorial. Or you could use safety eyes or animal eyes if you prefer. You'll also need some fiber fill. I'm also going to use craft wire to make a wire skeleton for my doll. I'm using 22 gauge craft wire. I like this wire because it's a little thinner and a little easier to bend with your hands. You can find a link to my craft wire doll skeleton tutorial in the description below, or click the link at the end of the video. In that video, I made the skeleton to fit my original doll design. Even though this doll is a little thicker than that doll, I'm still going to make the skeleton exactly the same size. You don't need to make a skeleton for your doll, but if you want to make a doll with a neck, I highly recommend that you use something to reinforce the neck so that the head doesn't droop. I won't be adding the skeleton until part 2 of the video, so if you like, you could wait to make the skeleton until then. Finally, you'll need yarn. I'm going to use this cafe latte from Red Heart Super Saver. I've also used coffee, warm brown, and buff from Red Heart brand to create other skin tones. You can use any Aran or worsted weight yarn in any color you choose to make your doll. And if you like, you can find the written pattern for these dolls in my Ravelry store. The link to that will be in the description below. First, I'm going to create a magic circle with 6 stitches of single crochet. If you want to see how to make one of these in more detail, check out my Beginner's Crochet Lessons series. You could use a couple of methods to begin your work, like a chain 3 and slip stitch, or a single magic circle. I'm going to use a double magic circle because it's just more secure and neater looking, but if you're going to add hair to the top of the doll's head, this part is going to be covered up, so you don't really need the clean finish that you get with a double magic circle. So use whatever method you prefer. Next, I need to increase to make the top of the head bigger. I'm going to increase 6 times for every row. Since I have just 6 stitches in this row, I'm going to increase every stitch. So first I'm going to find that chain 1 that counts as the first single crochet in my magic circle, and I'm going to insert my hook into that stitch, pull up a loop, and single crochet. And before I continue, I'm going to use my bobby pin to mark that stitch as the first stitch of my row. Now this side will count as the back of the work, but the first stitch of the row is going to drift over a little to this side as I work, so I'm going to have to account for that as I go later on. Now to increase, I'm going to single crochet again into the same stitch. And I'm going to do that for every stitch in this row. I'm going to single crochet 2 times into each stitch until I reach the end of the row. I've gotten to the end of my first row of increase. In the next row, I'm going to increase 6 times again, or every second stitch of the row, since I have a total of 12 stitches in the row. First, I'll remove my stitch marker and single crochet 1 time into the first stitch of the next row. then mark that as the first stitch. Now I'll increase the second stitch of the row, so single crochet two times into the next stitch. Then once again, I'll single crochet just once into the next stitch. And then to increase the second, I'll single crochet twice into that stitch. And I'm going to continue to increase every second stitch until I reach the end of this row. Then I'm going to do one more row of increase. You could increase your work as much as you like if you want to make a bigger doll. In the next row, you would increase every third stitch. In the next row, you would increase every fourth stitch, then increase every fifth stitch, and so on. Just continue to increase until your work reaches the width you want for the head of your doll. For my doll, I increased every third stitch in my final row of increase. If you want, you could also increase for fewer rows to make a smaller doll. So I've gotten to the end of my row of increasing every third stitch. Next, I'll remove the stitch marker and single crochet into the first stitch of the next row. For this next part, I'm going to continue to single crochet for 6 more rows to make the head longer. If you want, you could add more or less rows of single crochet, depending on the size doll that you're making. Just go on until you have the length that you want for the face. Now I've gotten to the end of 6 more rows of single crochet, I'm going to add the eyes to the front of the face next. Since the first stitch of my row is going to continue to drift from the back in this direction, I'm going to place the eyes a little closer to this side than exactly at the front middle of the face, so that the first stitch drifts more toward the middle back of the doll. So I'm going to place them about here, just to the side of the first stitch of the row. And once I've figured out where I want the eyes to go, I'm just going to pull the tails to the inside of the head using my hook. If they aren't quite lined up how you would like, you can just pull the tails back out and reposition. You don't have to do this, but once I'm done placing the eyes, first I'm going to just tie the tails of each eye together. Then I'll tie the tails of each eye to each other a few times on the inside of the head to bring the eyes closer together. This is going to shape the face a little bit. If you're going to do this, you should make sure that the eyes are a little further spaced apart before you sew them on. Then on the inside of the head, I'll sew each eye in place using the tails. But again, if you want, you could use safety eyes instead to make this a little easier. Next, I'm going to begin to decrease each row to create the neck. I'm going to do the same thing as I did to increase, but in reverse. So I'm going to do 6 decreases per row. When I was increasing at the top of the head, I last increased every third stitch, so now I'm going to decrease every third stitch. But you should decrease by whatever number you last increased by at the top of the head. Depending on how big you made your doll, you may need to decrease for a few rows. Just continue to decrease each row by the next descending number. Like if your first row is decreased every 5th stitch, then the next would be decreased every 4th stitch, then every 3rd, and so on. Then just go on until your doll's neck reaches the desired width. If you want to learn some different ways to decrease, or if you just want more practice with decreasing and increasing, check out my increasing and decreasing tutorial in my Crochet Lessons for Beginners series. The link to that will be in the description below. So I've removed my stitch marker and done the first stitch of my row, so I'm going to single crochet into the next stitch, and then I'm going to decrease the third stitch. So I'm going to insert my hook through the next 2 stitches, pull up a loop, and then I'll single crochet those 2 stitches together to decrease. I'm going to continue to decrease every third stitch all the way around in this row. So for the next decrease, I'll insert my hook through the next 2 stitches, pull up a loop, and single crochet together to decrease. I've reached the end of my first row of decrease. I'm going to decrease for another 2 rows, but before I finish my rows of decrease, I'm going to add a bit of fill to the head so that it'll be a little easier to get the fill into the hole. And I'm going to make sure not to overstuff the head. Then I'm just going to continue to decrease to slim down the neck even more. In this next row, I'm going to decrease every 2nd stitch. So I'll single crochet once into the first stitch, then into the next 2 stitches I'll insert the hook and pull up a loop, then single crochet together to decrease, and continue to decrease every 2nd stitch until the end of the row. Here's where things start to get a little different than my original design doll. For that doll, I did 1 more row of decrease in the same pattern, 6 times per row, decreasing every stitch of the last row. For this doll, I still wanted the neck to be a little smaller, but not as small as it would be if I decreased 6 times for another row. So in my last row of decrease, I decreased every 2nd stitch for 1 more row, so that I had a total of 4 decreases throughout the row instead of 6, and I ended up with 8 stitches total at the neck instead of 6. If you want, you can decrease for fewer rows, or decrease fewer times in the final row to create a wider neck, or decrease the full 6 times in the last row to create a thinner neck. You don't have to decrease your doll's neck this much either. If you want the neck to be even wider, you can skip this last row of decrease. It all depends on how big your doll is and how wide you want the neck to be. Now I've gotten to the end of my last row of decrease and I have 8 stitches total in my row, and the hole at the bottom of the head is the width that I want the neck to be. So I'll make the neck next. This step is entirely optional. If you want, you could just go straight into the body by skipping this step, To create the neck, I'm going to single crochet without any increases or decreases for 3 more rows. You could do more or less rows if you want a longer or shorter neck, it all depends on the look you want. Just go on until the neck is a length that you like. Alright, I've completed the neck, so now I need to increase to create the shoulders of my doll. Since I decreased every second stitch of the row in my last row of decrease instead of every single stitch, I ended up decreasing 4 times in my last row instead of 6. So now, for my first row of increase, I'll be adding those 4 stitches back into the row by increasing 4 times every second stitch of the row. So single crochet 1 into the first stitch, then single crochet twice into the second stitch of the row. And repeat that until the end of the row. But in the next row, I'm going to change where I'm placing my increases to shape the shoulders. So if you have 12 or more stitches in your row, you should skip to the next step to begin the shoulders. So I finished my first row of increasing after the neck. Now to increase for the shoulders, I'm going to increase 3 times per side where I want the shoulders to go. I'm going to do this for 2 more rows, but you can go on for as long as you like until the shoulders of your doll are the right width. So first, I'll single crochet until I get to where I want the first shoulder to go. I single crocheted 2. Then I'll increase into the next 3 stitches at the side. Here are my 3 increases. Now I'm going to single crochet until I get to the other side where I'm going to do 3 more increases for the other shoulder. I single crocheted 3 times here. Now I'll increase the next 3 stitches. Then single crochet until the end of the row, which for me was just 1 stitch. I've done my first row of increase for the shoulders. Now I'll just repeat that for another row, with 3 increases on each side of the body. Here I single crocheted 2 before increasing 3 times. Then I single crocheted 9 in between the shoulders. Then increase 3 more times for the other shoulder. And single crochet until the end of the row, which was once again just one stitch. Alright, I finished with two rows, increasing the shoulders each 3 times per row. Now I'm going to make the armholes right under where I placed the shoulders. To do that, first I'm going to single crochet until I reach the 6 increased stitches that I made at the first shoulder in the previous row. This is another part that I'm going to do slightly differently than my original design, because I think it works better for shaping the armholes. Maybe eventually I'll redo that other tutorial using this technique for the armholes instead. So into the first 2 stitches of the 6 increased stitches at the first shoulder, I'll create a decrease using a single crochet, then a double crochet. To do this, I'll pull up a loop in the next stitch as though I was just making a single crochet, but instead of finishing the stitch, I'll leave it open on the hook. Then I'll yarn over and pull up a loop in the next stitch, and pull another loop through those 2 loops, as though making a double crochet, but again I'll leave the stitch open on the hook. Then I'll pull another loop through the remaining loops on my hook. Next I'll chain 4, skip the next 2 stitches, and into the last 2 stitches of the 6 increased stitches, I'll create another decrease, this time using a double crochet then a single crochet. So I'll do this the same as before, but in reverse. First I'll yarn over and pull up a loop in the next stitch, and pull another loop through those 2 loops as though making a double crochet, but leave the stitch open on the hook. Then pull up a loop in the next stitch as though making a single crochet, then pull another loop through the remaining loops on the hook. Now I've completed the first armhole. If you're making a larger doll, you may want to skip and chain more stitches to make a larger armhole. You can go ahead and do that, just make sure to keep the same ratio by skipping 2 less than you chain. For example, if you chain 10, skip 8, if you chain 8, skip 6, if you chain 6, skip 4, and so on. Now my first armhole is made. Next I'm going to add some curves to the doll's chest. This is obviously optional, you can just make your doll with a flat chest if you want. To do that you could just continue to single crochet as normal in between the armholes, but for this doll I'm adding a bust. So to do that, I'm going to increase and then decrease the doll's chest. There are a ton of different ways that you could shape the bust of your doll. You could increase 6 times per row for a larger bust, or increase 4 times per row for a slightly smaller bust, or for an even smaller bust you could increase just 2 times per row. Or again, don't increase at all to create a flat chest. In my original tutorial, I increased in the front of my doll 6 times per row. For this doll, I'll increase at the front 8 times per row to create a very large bust. So I'm going to add 4 increases to the front of each side of the chest. This is going to be very similar to what I did to make the shoulders, except I'm going to put my increases at the front of the body instead of at the sides. Okay, I've done my first 4 increases, now I'm going to single crochet 1 in between, and then I'm going to do my next 4 increases. Alright, I finished my 8 increases. Now I'm going to create the next armhole the same way I did the first. So I'll repeat the process I did on the other side to create the second armhole. Into the first 2 stitches of the 6 increases, I'll create a decrease using a single crochet then a double crochet by pulling up a loop in the next stitch, as though I was just making a single crochet, then yarn over, pull up a loop in the next stitch, pull another loop through those two loops as though making a double crochet, and pull another loop through the remaining loops on the hook. Next, chain 4, skip the next 2 stitches, and into the last 2 stitches of the 6 increases, create another decrease with a double crochet, then a single crochet, the same way as before, but in reverse. Yarn over and pull up a loop in the next stitch, pull another loop through those 2 loops as though making a double crochet, pull up a loop in the next stitch as though making a single crochet, then pull another loop through the remaining loops on the hook. Now I've completed the second armhole. Now I'll just single crochet until the end of the row, which is, once again for me, just 1 stitch. At the end of this row, I'll take a break for now, so that the video isn't too long. Here's what we have so far. If you're interested in the written pattern for this project, you can find the link to my pattern store on Ravelry, where you can find all of my designs in the description below. If you enjoyed this tutorial, you could press the like button or share it on social media, and if you'd really like to help out the channel, you can donate to my Patreon. You can get some pretty cool perks through Patreon, like seeing my videos early, access to some of my prototype patterns, and discounts in my Ravelry store, depending on your level of donation. You can find out more about that at patreon.com/fairyrings. You could also subscribe and click the bell icon so that you don't miss the next video in this series. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!